Christmas Eve, it's nighttime. I just went through a little flow session where I'm squatting, opening up my groin, breathing, doing some yoga-like movements, and now I got to thinking about your ankles. So when people come to classes here, I've noticed people's ankles are super, super tight. Why? Because they tend to default in this position when your feet are turned out, okay? When your feet are turned out, you're not training the arches of your foot. The reason why the arches of your foot are so important is because there's a spiral-like activation that happens from your arch all the way up to your leg, your hamstring, your glute, your pelvic floor, all the way up to the rest of your body. And if you don't train yourself in that fashion, you're gonna have a lack of access to these big muscle groups, your hamstrings, your glutes, your back, your pelvic floor, so on and so forth, okay? So you gotta train your arch. And if you're turned out like this, there's several things going on. You're over-tightening your ankle. So you have a lot of tightness and joint compression right here, where you're tied around the lateral aspect, the inner aspect, and even the anterior part of the ankle, okay? And the reason why you can't squat properly or get into the movements you need to, and you keep feeling like you're about to fall over, is because you have lack of mobility at the ankle joint. And if you feel knee pain or you feel hip pain, you gotta think about what's upstream and downstream from those points of pain. And it's never just the point of pain that's the issue. It's always looking downstream, up, downstream and upstream, because it is a holistic being that you're dealing with. You're not a car. You're just pulling parts out and putting parts back in. You gotta see how the whole structure works. There are different structural works. There are different torques being put on the joints and different angles. So you have to understand that. So again, if you feel pain, look upstream and downstream. But the most important thing you can do is open up what's closest to the point of contact. Your point of contact with the ground is your foot. So you have to open this stuff up so you can transfer force appropriately to the rest of your body, okay? So let's figure out what we can do. The most basic thing you can do is squat. And not just squatting with your feet out, I mean squatting with your feet straight. It's gonna be a challenge. Ankles will burn. That's a part of the process, okay? Part of the process. So I recommend initially getting to a column, a door handle, a wall, whatever you need to do. Grab onto your column for support. Get your feet straight, okay? Feet are straight. And I want you to begin to lift up through your arches. So come on over this way so you can see this real quick. So come on over. Right at the arch. So the way I want you to lift up your arches, I want you to focus on pressing down into the ground with the base of your big toe, right here. And I want you to focus on lifting up through your arch right here, okay? Not here, but here, okay? You wanna do that with both feet and pick a stance with where you're comfortable, where you can get in a position and hold it with your heels on the ground. If you can't get into your position here, walk your feet out wider. Okay, so I'm gonna go pretty close for me, right here, lift up through my arches, and then I'm gonna sit down in a squat position. Now notice I'm not just leaning back, okay? I want you to actually challenge the ankle joint by trying to get the knees over the toes a little bit. Keeping the heels down, you kind of rock here into this foot right here and rock the opposite way. Rock back and forth and spend at least 5 minutes here, minimum. And if you can't do that yet, work to 2 minutes first. The next week do three, the next week do four, five, so on and so forth. Eventually build up to about 15 to 20 minutes in a squat. And when you can do that, then start to come off your column right here and just go into a basic squat pattern right here. Okay? If this is too hard still, I'd recommend going over to a wall. And this you can do anywhere. Just get to a wall. The closer you have your feet to the wall, the more your ankles are challenged. The further your feet are off the wall, the less challenge you have. So I'm gonna get close, I'm gonna slide my butt all the way down the wall. Now I have back support. And now I can actually maintain this position for a longer period of time because I have this back support. And this you can do as a passive thing while you're reading a book, while you're listening to music, talking on the phone. I think that's probably the best thing you can do while you're talking on the phone is sit into a squat, sit and hang out. Open up your ankles. If this is too easy, walk your feet further back towards the wall. You're gonna feel a lot more challenge at the ankle joint. Posture's nice and straight. Again, work on breathing like we talked about the last video. Deep, deep diaphragm breaths. Okay, so deep, deep breaths while you're going. And if that is still not sufficient, then I challenge you to move on and do something else to open up your ankles. And what you can do here is actually just find a box or a wall, okay? Or something to press your foot up against. I'm gonna use this box right here. You can use a pillow, you can use an ab mat or a cushion. Get your heel up against your pillow, get it as close as possible to your box or your wall. Your toes are flexing up. Once you get to this position, I want you to lean forward, like so, keeping your knees straight, lean forward, take a deep breath. You're gonna feel a tight, tight stretch all the way from your ankle joint to your calf, to your hamstring, all the way to your glute. While you're holding this, I want you to rock your hips back and forth, okay? Back and forth, getting into those corners, that angle. Then switch sides. Spend at least minimum 2 minutes per side, okay? 2 minutes per side, same thing here. Okay? And then work up to three, work up to four, work up to five. And then retest your squat position. What you'll find, just from doing a couple of minutes of this, you'll find yourself way more open just from doing that stretch right there and just opening up your ankle joint, okay? So those are just two basic things you can do. Squat against the column right here. Work up to 5 minutes, then 10, 15, 20, 30. Increase by like a minute or two each week. Or you can go on the wall, like we talked about. And then add this stretch, at least 2 minutes per side, every day. Okay, you gotta remember that the amount of time you spend sitting at a desk or running, because running does what? Much of this, not enough of the opposite. If that is greater than the proportion of time you spend in these movements, you're gonna have tight ankles. You're going to have dysfunction in the rest of your body. You're going to have pain. So you have to make this a priority. Engineer a way to get this stuff in, okay? Do this while you're brushing your teeth. Do it while you're on the phone. Whatever it takes, get it done. Do this while you're reading a book. Make it your breathing time. Get it done, guys. Peace.